The funniest and most unnecessary thing about Logitech G733 is that it drastically changes. First stage, mediocre gaming headset with, yes, futuristic design. To a second stage, an almost transcendental experience with absolutely stellar 3D scene. And what makes such ungodly, unholy difference, you ask? Oh, I'll tell you, don't worry. First of all, of course, price. 200 Freedom Macaronis, up to 200. And yes, it's a premium segment, no doubt. However, for a wireless headset with RGB and from a reputable brand, well, now price looks, well, not that bad. And Logitech delivers, at least in looks. G733 is a very futuristic one. Very bright, like anti-class, but in a good way. It is very colorful. Not that one, but yes, colorful. Color schemes can be very different and, by the way, head straps can be even changed to another one. If you, of course, will be able to find it. And buy it. In the box you'll find not only Type-C to Type-A cable for charging, but also detachable mic and USB receiver, which looks ginormous, like a flash drive and not small flash drive, giant one. And it looks nothing like Logitech Unifine, which is very telling. You'll understand why a little later. The headset itself has one volume wheel, one power button and one button to, as manual says, disable mic. The embouchures are clothy and breathing, which is, I'm sorry, almost my fetish. And they can be changed and they can be washed. And you know what? Even battery can be swapped. Well, for another proprietary one, which is not even at sale at time of this video, but still, the hassle to do that is absolutely minimal, if you believe the manual, of course. Still, there is no mini jack and no additional buttons. There is RGB at the front, which is nice, but you cannot change it or even disable, which is absolutely not nice. And based on all of this, we can safely assume that G733 is a wireless-only headset for gamers only, not for music or phones. Because the only way to use it is to use proprietary receiver. It, of course, can be used with a smartphone via dongle, but quality of the sound, well, it is loud and not too shabby in terms of deformation and high loudness. But it is very not sparkly, not bassy, just simply insipid and flavorless. Sounds like a nice studio headset though, which was a very big surprise for me, but a welcome one. However, for gaming headset, it is very mediocre, to say the least. And all of this was a result of, well, first stage of usage. The second one begins from installing Logitech G Hub on your laptop or PC. And my main problem with it, G733 is very unfriendly with this app. It just won't connect. It won't be seen. And I have no idea why. Is it because I did not connect mic to a headset at the first time? Or because my G-Hub was so buggy it even rejected to be reinstalled? I don't know. The only thing I know is that I could not connect goddamn headset to my PC for a single 24 hours. And I am not the only one. Still, after all this hassle, connection was established, almost by itself, by auto-updating. And after all of it, you will get control over all of G733 features and headset will become phenomenal. First of all, DTS:X V2, 3D sound, so detailed on options, it's not even funny. The quality of the sound is absolutely stellar. Bass can be changed, high pitches can be modified. Even the button that disables mic becomes absolutely optional to change. And you can assign it to almost any function possible, from a simple mute to macros, to even powering down PC. And power button on a single press summons pretty British voice to announce battery left. And even the RGB can be disabled or synced with other Logitech peripherals. But there is a catch. everything returns to zero after headset is disconnected from G-Hub. Literally, nothing is saved inside any memory here. I don't even think it has a memory. Even RGB returns to its undisable mode, which is, I'm sorry, absolutely criminal. G733 works up to 30 hours on one charge without RGB and like 15 hours with it. It has the best 3D sound scene I've ever heard in my life. In a tactical games like Modern Warfare or R6 Siege, headset becomes pretty much a hardware cheat. And of course, it resets too, to a mediocre sound without any 3D scene. It resets too after you disable it. And USB receiver is all the way to connect the headset. Maybe receiver does much less latency than Bluetooth or even Logitech Unifine USB plug, but it has the same working length and you will be absolutely needing at least one USB just for this headset. So this is pretty much it. Logitech G733 is phenomenal headset with perfect 3D sound, nice microphone, stellar design, modularity and even RGB. But it is pretty much on laggy life support away from becoming very mediocre headset. Too mediocre for its own good and its own price. Good luck connecting it to G-Hub, because it will either change your perception on gaming headsets forever, or it will make you sorry for $200 you've paid for it. And in the comments, if possible, tell us how often do you use your PC headset with anything besides, well, PC. Huge thanks to MBLOG Shop for providing a place to make a video. Link will be in the description below. As always, like, subscription and pushing the bell icon is very encouraged and help us immensely. My name is Denis Zaichenko for Root Nation channel, and I'll see you next time.